Anna Maglione was 10 years old when she left her mother and several siblings behind in Benevento, Italy, to join her father and two eldest brothers in America. John C. was 14 years old, living in war-torn China, when he and his brother and mother obtained secret passage in the belly of a merchant ship bound on a 17-day journey to San Francisco. Anna, her father, and brothers settled in New Jersey, where she became the de facto woman of the house, cooking, cleaning, and caring for her brothers. John's family struggled financially, and when his father accepted a posting to the Vatican back in Rome, the harrowing decision was made to leave John and his older brother Charlie in an orphanage in New York. Despite the hardship, John excelled at school, earned scholarships to college and graduate school, and became a top electrical engineer in the U.S. Defense Department. He later became a vice president at an electronics firm, where there was a beautiful young receptionist named Anna. It didn't take long for sparks to fly. John persisted and was actually Anna's first date. While both families had problems with the interracial marriage, that didn't unsettle this lifelong romance. John and Anna married and raised five children together: Susan, Debbie, James, Michelle, and Allison, the seven C's.
The seven C's describe essentially the world, the ocean around us, the whole world. And so I thought seven C's sort of rhymes.
Five children, two of us, seven C's.
In the 1970s, John was recruited by John Malone to join Gerald Electronics, where he became enamored with cable TV. He then joined Showtime, and in 1984, he was recruited once again by John Malone to join TCI as senior vice president to help rebuild the nation's largest cable TV operator.
When the Japanese were about to do another Shanghai on Johnny, you know, he invents digital compression. I'd say that's one of the greatest achievements in our industry.
In 1991, with the backing of TCI, John launched the Stars and Encore channels, today known as the Stars Entertainment Group. In 10 years, it became the largest programmer in the world. Today, the group has over 57 million subscribers and a market cap of $3.3 billion. There is no doubt that John could not have succeeded without Anna by his side. By 2003, John and Anna had decided it was time to retire, to spend more time with family. Little did they know, it was the beginning of much more. That same year, their granddaughter, Sophia K. Witten, was born with Down syndrome. At 3.5 months old, she survived open-heart surgery and emerged as a beautiful and brilliant tiny miracle. Shocked that Down syndrome is the least funded genetic condition by our National Institutes of Health, despite being so prevalent, John and Anna partnered with CU's Anschutz Medical and Boulder campuses to establish the first and only academic home for Down syndrome in the U.S. This academic home features basic research at the Cernik Institute at the University of Colorado School of Medicine and at the University of Colorado Boulder, medical care at the C Center at Children's Hospital Colorado, and outreach, advocacy, and fundraising at the Global Down Syndrome Foundation.
Well, for me, it was really having a place at the Children's Hospital. If you have a child with Down syndrome, you can go to the C Center, and everybody is there, any doctor, anything that you could think of to help your child. That's a dream come true.
One of the big reasons a lot of us came out here was the idea there has been very little clinical research. And so there's the opportunity out here with the backing of the C Family Global and also this phenomenal hospital. And there is no other place in the country like this or in the world.
In 2009, John and Anna, along with their daughter Michelle, tapped their friend music icon Quincy Jones to help start the annual fundraiser. The Be Beautiful, Be Yourself fashion show was born.
It is so hard to put these types of events together.
This is what life is about.
This is really what life is about.
Thank you for working on new ways to fix our faulty hearts, our bad hips, and our poor vision. Thank you for helping to find new ways for us to learn and live and work along with everyone else in our communities. Thank you for focusing your efforts to improve our lives.
In addition to life-saving medical care, the Global Down Syndrome Foundation Fashion Show underwrites groundbreaking research including Alzheimer's disease, cancer, and autoimmune disorder research.
We have world-class scientists coming together to look for solutions, to understand the condition. We have Tom Blumenthal, Huntington Potter, Joaquin Espinoza, Kathleen Gardner, Fran Hickey, Dee Daniels, Pat Winders, and the list goes on and on, both in science to clinical care.
Google is great to work with because they provide funding for our staff, but they also challenge us to be more and better. Global Human Rights Center is happily working together in Hawaii, in D.C., and even all around the world.
Today, the C's are one of the largest single source of funds for Down syndrome care and research in the nation.
Well, we've also been very lucky to have lived in this country, which is the greatest country to live in. It's given us as immigrants the opportunity to do better in life. And having done so, it's only natural that we want to give back.
What's next? Engaging the needs of adults with Down syndrome.
The questions that are asked is, if the child outlives you, what happens? Where do they go? Who will take care of this person?
And that's a reality, as the life expectancy of people with Down syndrome has now moved into the mid-60s.
While helping so many others, Anna and John have had some challenges of their own. At the end of 2013, Anna was diagnosed with stage 4 uterine cancer.
I just refused to be a victim of this illness. I tried to really live my life as if I'm not ill, and it's not always that easy. But maybe I would like 10 years more in my life. If not, I've had an incredible life. So I am very thankful for what I've had so far. But having John with me, I'm able to face anything. And it's been really an incredible life that we've had together. So hopefully we'll be together a little more.
Anna is essence of goodness and empathy. And she's very caring, and she wants to leave this world at a better place than when she came. We've been blessed with a very fortunate life in this greatest country in the world, and we enjoy it.
When we first started on this adventure, we were thinking about the future of Sophia and for millions of people in the world who have Down syndrome. And yet, in the scientists that we've met, those scientists have really led the way in the treatment for my mother's cancer. In the end, Sophia is really helping with my mother and her diagnosis and her outcomes. That's pretty karmic.
Anna and John have not only lived the American dream, they represent a deep and abiding love for each other, for their extended family, and for their granddaughter, Sophia.
I love basketballs. I love sports.
This love has helped them to use their resources for the good of all, for dedicating their lives to a brighter future for Sophia and all people with Down syndrome. We are proud to present Anna and John J. C. with the 2015 Quincy Jones Exceptional Advocacy Award.